Yes.
Welcome. Earlier we looked at what economics is it not? What did we say economic is?
Science.
Social science. We studies what? Human behavior. As a relationship between what? Ends and scarce means which have what, alternative what, uses. Is it not? Is that not? That's the definition of what economics. I went on to define the various terms used in economics, like want. What did we say want is? Things you need. Is it not? Then we'll say choice. What is choice? Choice. The act of selecting from different things. Is it not? The act of choosing. Then we'll learn about scarcity. Scarce. What is scarce? It's not readily available. Then we looked at opportunity cost. What is opportunity cost? Good. The alternative that is left unpicked. You understand? The alternatives that are left unchosen when you're picking from your scale of preference, is it not? So those are the things we looked at, isn't it? Today we are going to look at the economic systems. What are the types of economic systems that we have in the world? In some countries, when you go there, you find out that government is controlling everything. You don't need to work. Like in the socialist Cuba, there's a country called Cuba. You understand? You don't need to own your private business. You work for the government. In the end of the day, government pays you. Is that clear? But in some economies, like in the USA, you find out that the people own most of the business. You understand? They just pay tax to the government. Is that clear? If you come to an economy like the one we have in Nigeria, government owns some things and some things are owned by individuals. Is that not clear? Is that not so? Like the NNPC is owned by what? Is it the government or individual? Government. But we have other oil companies that are owned by individuals, like Total, Elf, isn't it? Good. So your economy can either be mixed economy, capitalism or what? Socialism. Is that clear?
Either mixed economy, capitalism or socialism.
We did something like that in government, isn't it? Good. Not something new with you.
Yes, you know. So mixed economy is an economy in which both public and private ownership of where there is what? Both public and private ownership of means of production and distribution exist together in a country.
You understand? Like in Nigeria,
both the public and the private people, they own the means of production and distribution. Capitalism or free market economy is a type in which the means of production and distribution are owned by
private individuals. Is that clear? When you talk about capitalism, it is owned by what? Private individuals. Can you see that? Capitalism owned by what? Private individuals. Socialism, the means, socialism or centrally planned economy, the means of production and distribution is controlled by the what? State or government. You understand? Or the what? Public sector. Is that clear? So in capitalism, you have private individuals handling the means of production and distribution. In socialism, you have public individuals or the state. Whereas in mixed economy, you have what? Both the what? What do we have in mixed economy? Good. Both the private and the public. Is that clear? Can you tell me the difference now if I ask you? So what are the three types of economic system we have? Mixed economy, capitalism, and socialism. So what are the differences?
Mixed by government and private.
Good.
By capitalism by private.
Good.
And by government
or states. Thank you. Isn't it very simple? Isn't it very simple? It is. So we are going to look at the features of the various kinds of economic system. What are the features of the various kinds of economic system? Features of the economic system. What do you understand by the type features? Characteristics, is it not? Characteristics. So number one, what are the features of let's start with capitalism.
what are the features of capitalism? What are the kind of things that you see in a country and you say this country is practicing capitalism? What are the things? Number one is that there is private ownership of properties. Number one is what? Private ownership of what? Properties. We see that most properties are owned by private individuals. If you go to America, you see Google owning some property. You see Apple, Facebook, individuals mostly. You understand? Number two, there is what we call existence of competition. There is what? Existence of what? Competition. If you go to America now, you see the tech giants like Google and Facebook, Apple, all of them are competing with between each other. Is that not so? When you buy phone, you buy Tecno, you buy Samsung, they are similar. You understand? One is trying to make his own application to be more better. Also, between Samsung and Tecno, which one is of more quality?
Samsung
is more quality, but it's costlier. But that's why plenty of people have Tecno, isn't it? But both of them have Android applications and they can be used very well, is it not? So there is always competition. Then there is what we call maximization of profit. There is what? Maximization of profit. Who can tell me the two telecommunication giants in Nigeria that are always competing? Globalcom and what? Globalcom and what? MTN. Airtel, Etisalat, isn't it? They are competing. All of them also want to make the maximum profit. But you know, if everybody is working for Nigerian government, like those people working in the ministry, is there competition in the ministry? If you go there, they will say, this thing not be your work, will not be government work. Why you be act like saying that you shall be part? You understand? That's what they say in government work. Nobody is willing to do extra things. Nobody is willing to do extraordinary things. But if you're working for a private firm, you have to be up and doing. If you're not, they will do what? They will sack you. But government, even if your guy wants to sack you, you just look at your guy and say, oh God, mind yourself, oh, this thing not your papa work, not be government work. You see the people that are working in government office, they will come to work very late. At the time, if they are doing activity in the village, they will just travel. They will not even take permission. Can you try that in a private institution? If you do it, they will just sack you. Understand? So there is this spirit of competition in private sector. They are trying to improve. You cannot just come there and do anyhow. There is individual satisfaction. Individual what? Satisfaction. Do you know what that means? If you are working for a private, if you are running a capitalism system of government, you go and do what you want. Like me, what am I doing? I'm into ICT and education, is it not? I just chose to. That's what I chose. That's what I derived joy in. I like teaching. When I teach, I'm happy. And that is why I set up this place. But if government say nobody should go and do anything but private, that everybody should go and work, they will just throw me into old Kutumbu secondary school and say I must go there and teach. Will I be happy? I will not be happy. One, that I will not be making maximum profit. You understand? Because government will be paying me salary. Or small amount of money, and some months they will not pay. Is that not what is happening, Salim? Some months government are owing they owe their workers, isn't it? So I will not be making profit, and I will not have satisfaction. I will not be happy. But because I'm doing what we call capitalism, I'm on my own. You understand? I'm a private owner of a business. I'm having what we call maximum profit, and I'm having what individual was satisfaction. Is that clear? Free market enterprise, that's another thing. There is what we call free market enterprises. Now we look at features of socialism. What are the features of socialism? Can you tell me the features of socialism? What are the type of things that you see in an economy and you say that this is a socialism economy? Number one, there is what we call joint decision making. You understand? Socialism is when government is controlling everything. There is what we call state ownership of means of production. So it's the state that owns the factories, the corporations. There is what we call non-market economy. Is that clear? Everything is there for you. There's no need going to stress yourself in trying to market your product, because your produce is also government produce and government gives it to everybody. There is no profit motive. There's what we call non-profit motive. Nobody wants to make profit because you're working for the government. There is promotion of welfare. That's the only good thing here. Promotion of what? Welfare. Because the government will use that money and the work you've done for it to take care of you. There are features of mixed economy. Features of mixed economy. How do you know a mixed economy when you see one?
Freedom of choice.
That is what? Freedom of choice. You understand? Freedom of choice. You can choose to work for government or work for yourself, isn't it? Or do any kind of thing you want. There is also joint decision. You can have what we call public-private partnership. There is joint participation of both the government and the private, is it not? Joint participation. You have the government and the private owning the means of production. There is checks and balances. There is what? Checks and what? Balances. Most economy in the world are now tending towards this mixed economy. Because the government check and balance what the private sector do. Because if the private sector, if they are producing any kind of thing, if they want to produce tire, they will go and do tire that is of low quality. The government has to be there. The government has to be there. The government has to be there to monitor what the private sector is doing. Don't leave my class while I'm in the class. Once you leave, you continue staying outside. And there is what we call economic freedom. That's the last feature of mixed economic freedom. Is that clear? Is that clear?
So those are the features.